This video is going to finish section 10.2, lecture notes. It's going to go over the last four problems, and I'm going to add a few extra ones just for you to have as an example, since this is an area that people tend to struggle with out of this section. This would be something I would definitely go back and do some extra practice on when you're studying for the quiz and the test. Remember, you can use the study plan. You can go back and redo homework problems. It will never take a check mark away in my math lab. So reminder again, the rules that are in this blue box that you should see on the screen are not new. You've been tested on this, but a lot of y'all should realize, thinking back to the test that you had this on, that it was super easy to make careless mistakes, especially if y'all were skipping steps. So some reminders that I said when we did this before, I said, if you have negative exponents, especially with division, please move them first. Remember, a negative exponent means change the location. So move it, make it a positive before you use the other rules. So we're going to look at number 17. And again, I want you to remember that the power rule and the product rule are different. So I'm going to just go back up here and highlight. Remember, this is my product rule, which says if I have the same base, I will add the exponents. And this is my quotient rule, which says if I have the same base, I will subtract my exponents. So remember the words there that you keep the base. That's a common mistake with number 17. So the base matches. So we're going to keep our base of 2, and we're going to add our exponents. Now, I'm going to just bring this down so you can see this separately. I'm adding a half to 1/4, and I have to get a common denominator here, which means I need to multiply the first fraction by 2 over 2. That gives me 2/4 plus 1/4. Denominators match. We keep our denominator. We add across our numerator. So my answer for this problem is 2 3/4. So you can do it inside the exponent above. I just was again showing that some of you, it confuses you with having too much in the same piece. So if you have this, you can always draw a box, bring it down, do it, and put it back in. Number 18 also has the same base. So we're going to keep the same base. This problem is going to be one that we are going to subtract the exponents. Now, again, when y'all watched her videos, she's going to subtract and bring it on top and make it a positive exponent in the last step. I've taught y'all that if we have the same base, we should know we're subtracting, but I say stop and look at this and say, where is there more? There's more in the denominator, so that's where it stays. I'm going to follow right now in the video using her technique. So 2/3 minus 7/3. In this case, the denominators already match, but if they don't, you do have to get a common denominator like number 17. So 2 minus 7 gives me a negative 5. Keep the denominator. But this is not the correct answer. The correct answer in this case means that you need a positive exponent. Look at the rules up here. So my answer for this problem is 1/5 5/3. Always double check that you can't simplify. So this is a quick reminder. This is a problem that I see people mess up on the test because they want to rewrite this in radical form because they were doing it like the problems before. This problem says simplify, write your answers using positive exponents only. So that should be a clue to you. Stop, write yourself a note on the test. I don't want radical form in my answer. I want exponential form. And remember, when we have exponential form with a fraction, I said take the root first. So if we look at this problem, number 17, I can't do the 4th root of 2. Number 18, I can't take the cube root of 5. That tells you you're finished with those problems. Going on to number 17 now, we're going to use the power rule, which says distribute your exponent to both pieces. So we have x to the half times 4, and we have y to the 2/3 times 4. If it helps, put that 4 as 4 over 1, because that's what it really means. So I'm going to multiply and simplify. So this gives me x to the 4/2. This one gives me y to the 8 thirds. I'm not finished. 4 halves is the same thing as 2. So you are expected to simplify that. So right now I have x squared y to the 8 thirds divided by y. And a lot of people make the mistake and stop there. But you should notice right now we have the same base top and bottom. So remember, I can rewrite this as y to the first power. So I have to get a common denominator. Some of you will wait on that step, but my common denominator between these two should be 3. So I can multiply that by 3 over 3. The x squared stays. I'm going to subtract using my quotient rule. So 8 thirds minus 3 thirds, because that's what I'm getting for the denominator exponent. Subtract these. 8 minus 3 gives me 5. Keep the denominator. Double check. Can I simplify? No. That is my answer. So notice I used my rules for order of operations. I did my exponents first, got rid of the parentheses. Then after I did that, I looked to see if I could collect any like bases together and so that I could simplify that problem and double check positive exponents only. So looking at number 20, there is actually multiple ways to do this problem. Some of you will simplify first inside, and honestly, that's probably what I would do. But I've watched a lot of people over the years, and most people actually will go ahead and distribute the exponent first. So that's what I'm going to do. But I do want you to realize you can simplify inside first, meaning get the X's together, the Y's together, and get them into a single piece, and then simplify further. So I'm going to distribute. So I'm going to get x to the fourth times a negative 2 thirds, y to the negative 6 times a negative 2 thirds. Not doing any of this in my head. I'm showing my work. So I'm distributing the negative 2 thirds to the denominator pieces as well. And if it helps, again, put those integers over 1 so you can see what you're going to do with the multiplication there. So I'm going to go to my first piece up here. This is going to give me a negative 8 thirds. So x to the negative 8 thirds when I multiply that piece. Here, I'm going to get a positive 12 over 3. So I'm going to write that down. A lot of y'all will realize that's 4. So if you can go ahead and simplify that, that's okay. But please just be careful with doing too many steps at once. Here, I'm going to get x to the positive 4 thirds. And here, I'm going to get y to the negative 2 ninths. Please differentiate here. This is 3 times 3. That's why I got a 9. On the other problems, I was keeping the base because it was a base. So now I've finished getting rid of the parentheses. Now I need to deal with combining any like terms. And I really stress this if you have a division problem. Please take the problem and make them positive exponents first. So what I mean by that is I'm going to now move anything that has a negative exponent before I try to combine anything together. So I'm going to bring this up here. So right now I have a y to the fourth left on the top. I'm just going to go ahead and write down what's staying first. And I have an x to the 4 thirds. That's staying because those are both positive. Okay. And in this case, I'm going to move the x to the 8 thirds down. And I'm going to move the y to the 2 ninths up because that's dealing with positive and negatives. And again, we move them across the division bar. At this point now, I have the product rule, because they are beside each other as a product. So I'm going to keep the base and add the exponents. So remember, I can rewrite this as 4 over 1. So since I want this that common denominator, I'm going to multiply that by 9. So that's going to give me a y to the 36 over 9 plus 2 over 9. All I did there was get a common denominator. In the denominator, I already have a common denominator, so 4 thirds plus 8 thirds. So now I'm going to combine them. So 36 plus 2 gives me 38/9. Denominator, x gives me 12 over 3. Double check, I cannot simplify the numerator, but I can simplify that fraction in the denominator. So my final answer here is y to the 38/9 over x to the 4th power. This is obviously the most complicated problem you're going to see, but if you go step by step and not skipping steps, you're going to do so much better with these problems. So what I want to do right now, again, you can pause in and rewind at any time you need to digest something. But now I want to just add another example, just one more for you to be able to see, one that's a little bit more complicated. So this is a problem I'm actually pulling just from the textbook. So this is another example. I'm going to have 3x to the 1/4 all cubed over x to the 1/12 power. So this is actually a good reminder of some other pieces. Just kind of keep in your head some of the ideas that we have for the final exam. So common first mistake is not to do the 3 as being a base because it's in that parentheses. You need to be careful. So either, again, put a 1 there so you're clear on that, because now I'm going to distribute that power of 3 to both terms, or sorry, not both terms, but both bases inside the parentheses. So I'm going to have 3, the first time, 1 times 3 is 3, and 1/4 times 3 would be 3/4. All over x to the 1/12. Just a kind of side note here, the reason why I had 1/4 times 3, that's how I got 3/4. Okay, so that's just how I got that piece right there. 1/4 times 3 over 1, which is 3/4. Now I'm going to simplify anything I can simplify. This should be simplified, which is going to be 27. And so for my x's, I have a quotient rule now with these pieces here. So I need to get a common denominator, which is going to be 12. So I'm going to multiply that by 3 over 3. That's going to give me x to the 9/12. A lot of y'all will take that one step and combine them into these two steps into one, which is okay. So I get 9/12 minus 1/12, which gives me 8/12. Don't make that trap and not finish this. 4 goes into the top and the bottom of this. So my answer is 27 times x to the 2/3 power. These are problems you're going to need to slow down on. Use extra space. Please don't skip steps. Okay. These are problems that are easy to miss on the test just because you're trying to move too fast.